What if I told you there is a tool that can cut your project timelines in half? Let's dive into ChatGPT Canvas, the ultimate productivity booster for founders and entrepreneurs. If you've ever felt overwhelmed by endless tasks or wished you had more time to focus on strategy, ChatGPT Canvas might just be your new favorite tool. Today, I'll show you exactly how it works and how to get the most out of it fast. So here's my ChatGPT. Let's close the sidebar just to have a clean space for now. So ChatGPT Canvas is quite easy to find. Where you see ChatGPT 4.0, you click on that and you'll be able to find in the second line GPT 4.0 with Canvas. Don't forget, ChatGPT is the user experience or the user interface that we use. But the technology behind it, the large language model, is GPT 4.0. And Canvas is a feature that uses GPT 4.0. This is why it's called GPT 4.0 with Canvas. It's still in beta, by the way, so it's going to get better. So as it says, collaborate on writing and code. Why collaborate? That's where the magic is going to happen in a second. So let's click on ChatGPT 4.0 with Canvas. So as you can see, nothing has changed. The only thing that has changed is this writing of ChatGPT 4.0 with Canvas. We know that now we are in Canvas mode. So let's get a scenario so that we can see the powers of ChatGPT Canvas. I'm actually going to work on a real project while we're at it. For the holiday seasons, I will host free workshops for founders and entrepreneurs. So if you're watching this and you're a founder entrepreneur, send me a message because you're going to love that. It's going to be free workshops of ChatGPT. So let's say that I was creating a marketing campaign around that. So I'll be using a real scenario and I will create a strategy for something real that I'm going to do in the Christmas season. I'd like to offer free workshops for founders and entrepreneurs. And this is my gift for thanking everybody because I've launched AI Operator, my dream business, and I'm super excited about it. So let's take that real scenario and let me prompt now. So I have prompted it as saying, first, create a document for a project I want to undertake during the holiday season. Why did I say create a document for a project? Because sometimes if you don't say that, it doesn't start with the document right away. And you'll see what I mean. The document, it's the canvas. And here I say, especially for Christmas and New Year's 2024, I plan to offer free workshops for founders and entrepreneurs as a way to thank my audience for their support. This initiative is also my way of giving back to the world after launching my dream business, AI Operator. I would love to dedicate a whole week to workshops and other activities during the holiday season as a significant thank you. In this document, let's outline the marketing strategy, including social media posts, timing, the number of workshops, and other details. Please ask me questions to help fill out the document and create a concise one-pager about this project. This is a real project, by the way. So I've sent that prompt. As what you will see now is, oh, quickly, a little box had appeared, and then suddenly that has transformed itself on the right section as a document. And on the left, as you can see, we've had holiday workshop plans, which is the name of the document. And underneath says, this draft should give you a solid starting point for your holiday initiative. Let me know which areas you'd like to refine or if there are specific elements you want to dive deeper into. The questions at the end can help us ensure everything aligns with your vision. So let me check my document. Okay, it's done some weird stuff. It says, Tim, this sounds like an awesome initiative. So what I'll do very quickly is show you a little bit of the features here. So don't forget, on the left, it's still your ChatGPT where you're talking to it. On the right, now we have this document. The canvas, you can close it. If I close the canvas, we're back to normal ChatGPT. But as you can see, there is this little box, which is our canvas. So we can open in Canvas. So I've opened our canvas again. One of the things that you can do very quickly is to decide on how big you want the canvas, how big you want the chat, right or left. This is fun. Some other quick features to look at is this little button that you see on the bottom right. As soon as I've hovered on it, I come with suggest edits. Then we have adjust the length. We have reading level. We have add final polish. And the most boring, in my opinion, add emojis. Or maybe the most fun. Yeah, not sure. We'll see in a second. As I can see very quickly in my document, it has some text that it should potentially had it inside the ChatGPT conversation and not in the document. And that's good, actually. It got workshop week overview, workshop topics, marketing strategy with the social media campaigns. That's perfect. Email newsletter campaign, website and landing page, other activities, key considerations, blah, blah, blah. All that stuff is there. That's awesome. So let's click on, first of all, suggest edits. So as you click on it, a white button to send the message appears. We click on that. And as we click on it, as you can see now, we're in this mode, which is stop, cancel. And on here, you can see on the left section that it's commenting. It's added 5 comments. Before I look in the comments, it says, I've added comments to help streamline the content, suggest reordering for greater impact, and recommend consolidation for clarity. Let me know if you'd like any specific adjustments based on these suggestions. Okay, let's check out these comments. As you can see now in the canvas, ChatGPT has highlighted the sections where it added comments in yellow. So let's check on this comment. First comment, consider simplifying the objective statement to make it more direct and impactful. This will help in capturing the reader's attention quickly. Okay, let's apply that. As we apply it, as you can see, the comment is moving around. On the left, it's starting to edit, and it just edited that section. Think about the incredible productivity of this. When we use ChatGPT, everything goes in a ChatGPT thread in the chat, and it's very hard to find bits. And when we edit, we potentially most of the time get the whole document again and so on. So it's quite annoying when you're doing processes, marketing strategy, or you're writing something. You're just trying to create a document and you struggle because you have to find the bits, you have to edit it, you get the whole thing, you wait for it and so on. But now we have the document on the right and the chat on the left. It's incredible. So I'll quickly check some of the comments. Second comment, the date section could benefit from more emphasis on flexibility, such as a note about potential alternate dates based on audience feedback. I'm not going to take that because I'm going to decide when the dates are. I'm going to check the next one. Workshop topics to start with a more engaging session, such as productivity hacks with AI to immediately capture interest. End with open Q&A, fireside chat for a strong community building conclusion. That's perfect. I will apply that. As I've applied that, again, on the left, it starts thinking, it's editing. On the right side, it goes from the beginning, it will go until there, and it will edit that section, right? And most of the time, actually, it does go through the whole document. As you can see, boom, it's reordered the workshop topics and start with a more engaging session. It tells us what it's done. Perfect. Let's check out very quickly the next comment. These questions are excellent, but consider adding more about audience expectations or probably regarding content depth to tailor the workshops better. Okay, let's apply that. These questions were supposed to be about me. Perfect. So I'd like to answer these. Well, I've finalized all the comments and I'm quite happy with what it has now. Apart this beginning section, I'm just going to delete it. As you can see, what's great is bam, it's a document. So now like a Google document, I'm able to edit the document itself. I can bold, I can use italics, or I can even change the heading to heading 1, heading 2, heading 3, or a body. Let's say heading 1. As you can see, also, a couple other things very quickly that we can do is if I choose a section, I get the option to ask ChatGPT. If I click ask ChatGPT, edit or explain, it says, right? And as you can see, we can send that. So it's kind of sending what you're doing normally on the left, right, on the chat, but just for that section. And here I can say, can you make this a little more detailed? So we're just talking about that section, and here we go. That section has become much more detailed now. We have the objective with some bullet points. Amazing. I select here, as it says number of workshops, 5 to 7. I'm actually going to do exactly 5 workshops and not 7, because Christmas is that week. It's 5 days. I do have 2 kids. I do have a family. I want to give back, but I'll do 1 workshop a day. So let's make sure to say that. So I've mentioned only 1 workshop a day for 5 days. As you can see, as I've edited there, it also wrote it here and boom, great. That's getting really good. I'm quite happy with this, where this is going. One of the features that I like as well is adjusting the length. Let's say that I wanted a bit more details. I'll go with longer and I will click that to make my document long. So it should be working on through the whole document, making it a little bit longer, giving a bit more details, adding some details here and there, which is good because I might start cutting it or it might inspire me because some of the wording will really inspire me for my social campaigns and how to announce it, what to say about these workshops and so on. Which is great because it's already started with teaser posts, workshop lineup and so on, right? So we've adjusted the length, it's just finished the job. So that's adjust the length. You can make it longer or longest or shorter or shortest, which is fun. So another one is reading level. Let's say that I wanted to send this to people who couldn't read well English. I could come to kindergarten. Let's test that for fun. All right, my content now, my document will be for kindergarten. What we want to do, we want to share some fun and easy workshop for business friends. So instead of entrepreneurs and founders, it's business friends. I actually like that. This is really fun. Share cool ideas to help friends use AI in their work, make new friends and help everyone share their ideas. Teach everyone how to use, this is really fun. I could do this for actually kids, right? But no, let's just go back. Which is cool, what is cool is that you can click previous version, it'll show you the version, and you can say restore this version or back to the latest version that I had. Let's restore this version. And I selected restore this version, boom, it's restored that version, which is great. So we are back with founders and entrepreneurs. So that's reading level. Reading level goes up to graduate school, and then it can go down to kindergarten. Another one is add final polish. I do like add final polish. When you're done with your document, you can click add final polish and it will check grammar, it will check things, it will make little tweaks, and it really does kind of bring it all together. It makes it all sound a bit better as well, especially with the new GPT-4o update that we had, which maybe you're not aware, but on November the 20th, we just got a brand new update to GPT-4o and things sound a bit better. They sound a bit more human, which is awesome. Right, so boom. So I've done a final polish. Just to show you how silly, but some might like it, is click add emojis and we'll send that to ChatGPT and it will start adding emojis here and there. I'm hoping it's going to add a lot of Christmas emojis because we're doing a holiday season. Okay, it's done a gift box. It's done some emojis. Here we go. Not many Christmas emojis. But you know what? I am shocked because I wouldn't like to have emojis. Usually I don't like to have emojis in my content on LinkedIn and so on. But to read this document, these emojis are starting to make sense. Well done, ChatGPT Canvas, for adding emojis that are very relevant in this document. Awesome. As you can see, just to recap very quickly, we have suggest edits, adjust the length, we have reading level, we have add final polish, and we have add emojis. Just to remind you that you could attach a file while in Canvas mode, but you cannot do a search anymore. So the search is unavailable. If you don't know about ChatGPT search, the video should be somewhere here, which I spoke about ChatGPT search last video. So I'm quite happy with my document. I could just copy the whole document and go to a Google document and paste it there. And my whole doc is ready. You can use ChatGPT Canvas with some amazing projects, any documents, processes, strategies, plans, anything that you're doing. It does have also coding features, which I'll cover in another video. Please subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much for watching this video about ChatGPT Canvas. When you get very confident and comfortable with ChatGPT Canvas, you're going to save a ton of times. No more copy and pasting, no more finding all these things. But let's not forget, this is just ChatGPT Canvas beta. When the actual version comes, you can be sure that it's going to be even more powerful. So watch my space, subscribe to my newsletter because you'll get more information about the workshops there and also on my LinkedIn.